guys, how's everyone doing? I'm Anime Intensity. Welcome back to my channel. The fall 2016 anime season is literally around the corner. I think it starts like this week or next week. Some anime are already debuting so soon, so suddenly. I feel like the, you know, summer 2016 anime season like just started. Like, what happened? Where did the time go? But anyway, so exciting to have the fall 2016 anime season finally approach us. I feel like this season doesn't have as many things that I really want to watch. I feel like the fall 2016 anime season is the season of sequels. Does anyone else get that vibe? Like, it's just the season of sequels. Lots of sequels going on, lots of sequels happening, but there are several anime that are not sequels that I'm excited for, and I'm just gonna let you guys know what I plan on watching. These are not the only anime that I plan on watching, but these are my top 5 anticipated anime that I really, really want to watch. Hopefully they end up good, because if they don't. Anyway, before I get started with my top 5, just want to say that these are not the only anime that I want to watch, like I said before. And if you don't see anime on my top 5 that you think is going to be really cool, whatever, feel free to comment below and tell me, like, why do you think that so-and-so anime sounds so cool and why I should watch it? You know, just because I didn't mention here doesn't mean that it's not going to be an awesome anime or that I'm not excited for it. I just had to pick my top 5 and, well, yeah. So starting us off at number 1, my really, really most anticipated anime is actually Drifters. Drifters is by the same guy who did Hellsing, so I'm expecting really cool things from Drifters. It has a lot of action just based on its PV, just like so much slicing and whatever. It focuses around this guy, he's a samurai, and one day he almost dies in battle. But instead of dying, he's actually transported into another world where other famous historical warriors all are just put there together, and there's just endless battles and crazy stuff, and that sounds amazing. I love the whole historical aspect to it. I love the action and just what we see in the PV. It looks like it's going to be so, so cool, and I just absolutely cannot wait for Drifter. So that's definitely one of my most anticipated for the fall 2016 anime season. I hope it ends up doing great. I mean, Hellsing is great, so I'm hoping that Drifters ends up being just as awesome. Personally, like I said before, I love historical things, so I think this is just really going to be great. The next anime I'm really excited for is actually Luger Code 1951. There's not really too much, like, known about this anime, I think. The PV really doesn't show too much, it's still very, very mysterious, but it focuses around this guy who's a linguistics professor, and he gets recruited to basically decipher the code of these werewolves, because these werewolves are using some kind of code to encrypt radio transmissions or something like that. And one day, you know, he's still having troubles, he can't really find out what this code is, but he ends up like capturing this female werewolf, and now he's going to use her to figure out the code and whatever. I'm like, okay. So I definitely love the whole werewolf aspect. I think that's really awesome. Based on the PV, still a little bit that I'm not really too sure about. Still kind of mysterious, and I am not sure if this is going to be really awesome or just kind of eh. But right now, I absolutely love that premise. I love the werewolves. I love deciphering codes and stuff like that. It's a fantasy anime, and I think it's by Studio Dean, which has made a lot of anime that I really enjoy. So I'm definitely going to be checking out Luger Code 1951. Also, 1950s, like, there's a lot of anime this season that takes place in the past. I don't mind that. I like that kind of stuff, so that's pretty cool. The next anime I'm really excited for is actually Shumatsu no Izetta, and this is an original anime. We know how those can usually go. You know, they're either really good or really bad. Shumatsu no Izetta features a gorgeous, like, red-headed main character, and I think that's really cool. Right, just looking at the poster, it's like, wow, this looks very interesting, and she's holding some kind of like weapon, and it looks really cool. And there's not too much to the plot that I've seen so much, like, just reading the synopsis, I'm like, I don't really know what this is about. It's about, like, protecting a princess in the Alps during World War II or something, some kind of big war. Like I said, this is an original anime, but I love historical stuff, I love action, I love, you know, nature and stuff, and it looks really pretty just looking at the PV. Also, I am interested in the characters. The art animation looks very, very well done just based on the trailer. And I'm just kind of like really excited for Shumatsu no Isetta. I think this is going to be a really awesome original anime. Can't wait to see what it holds. Definitely on my to watch list. The next anime I'm really excited for is Maho Shoujo Ikusei Keikoku or something like that. Some really long Japanese title. That anime, it looks really, really interesting. That is the twist anime of the season. It's basically about this whole project called the Magical Girl Raising Project, which allows people to become magical girls if they want to. Not everyone, but like certain individuals can become magical girls. And one day, there are just too many magical girls in one area. So they're like, we have to get rid of some. We have to get rid of half of these girls. And now it's gonna be a murderous death match. Like, okay. Just look at this poster! They look so cute! How are they all gonna end up dying? No! I hope not. Well, they said half, so half might end up dying, and that's sad. Just looking at the poster, you think, oh, this is gonna be a silly magical girl anime, happy, happy, fun time. No! I am very nervous. I don't want to get attached to any of these girls if they end up dying, and no! And also the big question for me is, are they going to be facing each other, trying to kill one another, or is some kind of outside force or enemy going to try to kill these magical girls? Like, I'm not really sure which is going to be involved in this anime, but either way, that sounds awesome. Magical girls fighting to the death. Very, very interesting. Something I'm excited for. I hope it goes well. The fifth anime that I'm really, really excited for is actually Watashi ga Motete Dousunda, or Kiss Him, Not Me. I think that anime is gonna be so much fun. The manga is tons of fun. It's funny. It's just, it's like a romantic comedy, and basically it revolves around this girl who is a fujoshi. So she'd rather see boys kiss each other than them kiss her. You know, she lost a ton of weight because one of her favorite characters died in like a manga or whatever, and she lost a bunch of weight, and then a guy started taking interest in liking her. But the problem with that is that she's not interested in them. She wants them to be interested in each other. It's just such a funny premise, and I love that. The manga is available on Crunchyroll Manga if you like to read it. It's definitely a fun read. Should be a fun anime. Very excited for that because I need some laughs in my life. So very, very excited for that as well. Oh, before I forget to mention, I'm actually really excited for Hibike Euphonium Part 2, Season 2. I'm really excited for that because I remember loving Hibike Euphonium the first season, and that last episode just made me want more. I was like, there needs to be a Season 2. Please let there be a Season 2. And we are getting a Season 2. So I'm very, very happy. So yeah! So those are the top 5 anime that I'm really excited for the fall 2016 anime season. If you have your own top 5, make sure to comment below and let me know what they are. So thank you so much for watching this video. Totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, subscribe if you like this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Deserves its own video. That's how big of news it is, and I'm just so excited to talk about it. Basically, New York is getting its own anime convention.